3, 2, 1, hold.
This is me attempting a max breath hold record. I started training about 3 months ago for 3 reasons. A, because I want to live a long, healthy life. B, because I want to be a free diver someday. And C, because I think holding my breath for 4 minutes would be a pretty cool party trick. So how does breath holding lead to longevity? There is a 70-year longitudinal Framingham heart study that looked at 5,200 subjects and concluded the greatest indicator of lifespan is not genetics, diet, or daily exercise. It's lung capacity. So I practiced increasing my lung capacity in 2 ways. Getting comfortable with high levels of carbon dioxide and increasing my oxygen uptake levels. Before practicing any of these exercises, I wanted to make sure I was doing diaphragmatic breathing, which means breathe in, belly out, breathe out, belly in. Our internal carbon dioxide levels tells us when to breathe. If we have too much carbon dioxide, it tells us to breathe out so that we can offload. If we have too little carbon dioxide, it tells us to breathe slow so that we can retain it. By breathing slow and less, we train ourselves to get comfortable with high carbon dioxide levels. Freedivers swear by CO2 tables, so that is where I started. The CO2 table challenges us to hold our breath for the same amount of time, but reduces the recovery period by 15 second increments. I'm a swimmer, so my breath hold going into this was 1 minute and 15 seconds. I quickly jumped to 130, 145, and 230 before ever trying oxygen uptake training. At this point, I learned that our lungs only absorb a quarter of the oxygen that's in the air. So by training ourselves to breathe slow and less and then doing breath holds repeatedly, our body adapts to taking more oxygen from that same breath of air. So here comes the O2 tables, another method that freedivers swear by. It challenges us to hold our breath for multiple rounds and then increase the breath hold by 15 second increments. In terms of a training session, I trained about once to twice a week, and after about 10 to 12 sessions, I was already at a 3 minute and 10 second breath hold. I was seeing benefits all around. I felt more in control of my breath. I noticed my heart rate going down. Even with my workouts, I would not get tired as quickly and I would recover faster. So I took on a 90-day challenge of doing breathing exercises every single day, either carbon dioxide training or oxygen training, never doing both on the same day because they are counterproductive. And on day 15, I hit it. I hit 4 minutes. It was so epic. My only rule for how much to train is if you feel dizzy, lightheaded, or have a headache coming on, stop. If you feel focused, relaxed, and in control of your breath, keep going. This is absolutely a workout where we're slowly adapting to harsh conditions, so recovery is crucial. This entire experience just goes to show if I can do it, so can you. So if you are interested in a healthy, long life, then consider adding breathing exercises to your daily practice. Linked here. So that's it from me. I will see you in the next video.
Holy shit. There you have it. Yo, I met my goal. What?